There are many reasons why people may want to move their IVF frozen embryos to a different IVF center. Why might you want to do this? What is the process? Is it safe to do? Stay tuned and I will tell you everything you need to know. First, what are some of the reasons why you may want to move your frozen embryos to another location? One of the most important reasons is to protect your embryos from government regulations. For example, in the United States, the Supreme Court recently repealed the Roe v. Wade decision. As a result, many states are now passing abortion bans and laws to try to give embryos the same constitutional rights as an actual living person. These so-called personhood laws are very dangerous. They remove your control of your embryos and give it to politicians and judges. For example, let's say you have completed building your family and want to dispose of your extra frozen IVF embryos. Under personhood laws, you would be charged with murder. The same could happen to you or your doctor if your embryo didn't survive the thawing process. You might even be required to attempt pregnancy with all of your remaining embryos rather than leaving them frozen. Testing of embryos would also become illegal. Even states without personhood laws, some religious folks would like to ban IVF entirely. They know that this is not popular, so they are crafting these anti-abortion forced birth laws in such a way that they can apply them to IVF embryos. They are hoping you won't notice. As a result, some people have already started moving their embryos to states or countries that don't have these horrible laws. Another reason that people may move their embryos is to take advantage of services that their original IVF program may not offer. For example, in recent months, I have had a number of patients move mosaic embryos to IVF 1 because their original IVF center does not transfer mosaic embryos. For more information about mosaic embryos, watch this video. Patients that move to a different city or state will also frequently move their embryos to a program that is closer to their new residence. In some cases, an IVF program may not offer long-term storage of embryos or is simply closing down. In these cases, patients may elect to store their frozen embryos at a long-term storage facility rather than at the IVF program itself. There are several long-term storage facilities in the USA. How is the transport of embryos accomplished? Embryos are normally stored in large tanks filled with liquid nitrogen. To move an embryo to a different location, a smaller shipping container with liquid nitrogen is used. The patient must notify both IVF centers of their desire to move their embryos. The center that is receiving the embryos will ask for the results of infectious disease testing on both partners who created the embryos in order to prevent possible contamination. Consent forms will need to be signed by both partners who created the embryos. Moving the embryos can be accomplished in one of three ways. If the distance is short, some people may elect to move the shipping container themselves. It is small enough to fit in a car. People who choose this method feel that nobody will take better care of their embryos than them. After coordination with both IVF programs, the first IVF program will load the embryos into the shipper. The patients will pick it up and bring it to the new facility. The receiving program will transfer the embryos into one of their larger storage tanks. Usually, a deposit will be required for the shipper, which is refunded when the patient returns it to the original IVF program. For short distances, messenger services may also be used. For longer distances, a commercial shipping company is used. These companies specialize in the moving of biological samples. They typically have their own shipping containers that they will send to your IVF program. At IVF 1, we have received embryos from all over the world in this way. Depending on the shipping container, the liquid nitrogen can keep the embryos safely frozen from a few days to several days. Is moving embryos safe? Generally, yes. Of course, accidents can happen. A delivery truck or airplane can crash. A tank might get damaged or lost. Delays in transportation could cause the liquid nitrogen to run low, causing the embryos to thaw. These are not likely events, but not impossible either. For this reason, people may elect to purchase insurance for the movement of their embryos. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: just because you created your embryos at one IVF center does not mean that you have to keep them there. Transporting embryos is a common process you may want to consider in various situations. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.